We had done in the previous video classification of bryophytes. I told you we have mainly two types of bryophytes. It's liverworts and mosses. If you remember, liverworts and mosses. Liverworts, we had done the word, it was hepaticopsida. You remember this word? H-E-P-A-T-I, hepaticopsida. Similarly, the mosses are known as bryopsida. B-R-Y-O-P-S-I-D-A, bryopsida. So, your bryophytes are divided into two categories, liverworts, mosses. If I say in common words, if I use the scientific words, bryophytes are again divided into two categories, hepaticopsida and bryopsida. Hepaticopsida, bryopsida. This is a very easy one. Mosses are comparatively very easy compared to the liverworts, that is hepaticopsida. Habitats, they can grow in dense areas, you know, any dense area where there is moisture, shady places. And especially you will find them as a mat, continuous growth in rainy season. But we have exceptions. Some even grow in flowing streams. Some are even found in deserts. Moving on to the plant body builder, the dominant stage of the life cycle is the gametophyte. The dominant phase, like we had sporophyte, we had gametophyte. But here in mosses, the dominant phase is this phase, gametophyte, not the sporophyte. The dominant phase of its life cycle is the gametophyte. Why do we call it as dominophyte? It's a dominating stage. Gametophyte because it's a longer life cycle stage. This gametophyte consists of two stages. The first, the earliest stage is what we call as the protonema stage. What is its stage called as? Protonema. If you remember, we had used this word in the previous video also. Protonema stage, this stage develops directly from a spore. Now, a spore first converts into the first stage, that is a premature stage, which we call as the protonema stage. And the second stage is what we call as a leafy stage. So, this leafy stage comes after the protonema stage. After the protonema stage, a bud-like structure develops. And this protonema, this structure, this stage is what we call as the leafy stage. In leafy stage, see beta, in protonema stage, how does it look like? It looks like a green, creepy filament thread-like structure. This bryophyte in protonema stage, this gametophyte stage, it looks like how? In the protonema stage, it looks like a green creepy filament. But in the leafy stage, it looks like an upright slender axis which has spirally arranged leaves. How does it look like here? It looks like an upright axis. It's not bending or it's not curved. It's an upright thread slender axis which has spirally arranged leaves. And remember that this stage, the leafy stage, it starts bearing the sex cells also. So from the spore, we had the first stage, that is the protonema stage, where it looks like a creepy thread-like structure. And then the second stage is the leafy stage, where the slender, it is slender but an upright structure which has a leaves also. In this stage, that is in the second stage, the leafy stage, it starts bearing the sex cells. So we started with the classification of bryophytes, we did liverworts in the previous video, that is hepaticopsida. The second category and the last category to tell you for bryophytes is bryopsida. We did the habitat, the plant body, the dominant stage I told you is the gametophyte. The gametophyte is again divided into two stages. The first stage, the premature stage is called protonema. From spores, first it gets into protonema stage. In protonema stage, it looks like a thin, slender, what kind of a structure? It's a creepy structure, filament-like structure. The second stage is a leafy stage. In leafy stage, the axis is upright and it has spirally arranged leaves. The most important thing to remember about the leafy stage is, it is at this stage that sex cells start developing. Rhizoids, we have done, they're long, they're multicellular structures, they help in fixation and absorption. We had already done the same thing in the previous one also. Reproduction is both vegetative as well as sexual. Vegetative reproduction either takes place by fragmentation, you know about this, and even budding. So what are the two modes of vegetative reproduction when we talk about mosses, when we talk about bryopsida? They are fragmentation and budding. Sexual reproduction, if you remember, the sex organ, the male sex organ was what? It was known as the antheridia. The female sex organ was known as archegonia. Both of them are produced. These organs are produced at the apex of the leafy structure. I told you these organ development starts at which stage? The leafy stage. So at the apex, at the top, these structures start developing. Look at the shape, it's a little different. The male sex organs are cup shaped and the female sex organs are bud shaped. Now, after fertilization, obviously what happens is zygote is formed. This zygote develops into a sporophyte. If you remember sporophyte, the same thing, it had what? It had the foot, it had the seta, it had the capsule. The capsule was containing the spores. The sporophyte, if you see, is more elaborate than liverworts. If you see the structure, you compare the structure of the sporophyte of liverworts and mosses, then in mosses, the sporophyte is more elaborate. It is more complex. Is it okay? Now, let's move on to the next one. The spores are formed after meiosis, and mosses have an elaborate system of spore dispersal. They have a proper elaborate system of spore dispersal. So the spores are dispersed in a very convenient, in a very systematic way when we talk about mosses. So that's all about mosses. We have two categories of bryophytes, liverphytes, liverworts and mosses, hepaticopsida and bryopsida. We have just done hepaticopsida in the previous video. We have done bryopsida in this video. I told you about habitat. You will find them as a mat in shady places, especially in rainy seasons. However, exceptions are there where you find them in flowing streams and in deserts. Coming to the plant body, I told you the dominant stage. We have both sporophyte and gametophyte stage. The gametophyte stage is more dominant. This gametophyte stage consists of again two stages. The first, the premature phase, directly after spores, is the protonema stage, where it looks like a green creepy filament. The second stage was a leafy stage, which comes after the protonema stage, where you have an upright slender axis which has spirally arranged leaves. The most important thing to remember in the second stage is this stage starts bearing the sex cells. Rhizoids are same long multicellular structures. They help in what? They help in formation and absorption. Reproduction is both vegetative and sexual. Vegetative you need to not much remember. It is by fragmentation and budding. Sexual reproduction same. The male sex organ called anthritia, the female sex organs are called archegonia. Now, but remember that these both the sex organs are produced at the apex, at the top of the leafy surface. The male sex organs are cup-shaped and the female sex organs are butt-shaped. After fertilization, zygote will be formed. Zygote will develop into sporophyte. Sporophyte will have again that base which is called foot, that long thin structure which is called seta, and the swollen structure called capsule. It is swollen because it contains the sporophyte, spores. Sporophyte is more elaborate in mosses compared to the liverworts. Now spores are formed after meiosis, and remember that mosses have an elaborate system of spore dispersal. See, you will find it a little difficult in this chapter because this is the second chapter, this is the only chapter. The first one was very simple, it was a very general chapter. Now we have started about classification. I would keep on suggesting you the same thing. I'll be taking up only one category in one day. Yesterday I took up what? I took up algae. Today I have taken up bryophytes. So I'll be just taking one category in one day. We have five divisions in the plant kingdom. First one was algae. I took one day for it. Bryophytes I take one day. Similarly, for all five, I'll take separate days. But remember, you need to complete your notes. You need to do your explanation and understanding on the same day. Try to put your queries or problems on the same day in the evening, because next day we'll come up again with a new topic. You can leave any sort of personal query on the personal number. I'll get back to you on my convenient time. But make sure you try to put up your doubts and queries on the same day, because next day you'll have a new topic coming up.